Good morning. It is 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and I got a question for you. Do you know where your light at? Mine is sitting right beside me. You're gonna need that bad boy, cause it's time to wake and bake. That's right, it's Miss Green Jeans and the Wake and Bake Show. Hey grandma, hey pop pop, hey, oh damn, he's sitting on the couch today. All right, we ain't gotta call him in the house. That's all right. Grandma, grab that stash box, cause this is gonna be a good one. Y'all gonna be saying, tweet this. What's up with that? Yeah, we gonna talk about Twitter today and shit that goes down.
Rolling up a dude when I wake up and contemplate how I'm gonna make bucks. Rent is due soon, I'm pitching. No different, I need to throw a change up. Before you start talking, get your weight up. That same dudes hating, they keep doing the same stuff. Kush loud, say what? We only look down and roll weed and pray up. And blow my smoke to the heavens above. And thank God just for showing me love. For giving me the strength when push came to shove. And making this beautiful bud, for real. Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Hit my knees and pray. I say goodbye to yesterday. I wake. Then I bake, and everything's okay, and everything's okay, yeah.
Hopped about the bed, grabbed my Ziploc. Y'all know my campaign, smoke trees, not rocks. Fell asleep with a dream, came up with a plot. Now I'm bleeding my block off private stock. Trying to stack me up a million. House on the hill for my wife and my children. Flow non-violent, but I'm talking about a killing. Could've called life, or I could've fell a victim. But I ain't never slipping. The night I hit my knees and pray. I try to talk to God, but he can't hear what I say. So if I go before my time, here's my soul to take. But if I get up in the morning, let me bake when I wake.
Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Hit my knees and pray. I say goodbye to yesterday. I wake, then I bake. And everything's okay. And everything's okay, yeah.
I'm all about feeling great on a day-to-day. Double-fisted red cups, I ain't ashamed to say. I'm trying to have the best summer I ever had. Inhale some good, exhale the bad. This is just the way things go first. I wake, then I bake, then I elevate the cup. Cause you only get to live life once. But if you do it right, then once is enough. So just remember that whenever times get tough. And keep faith within the God we trust. And remember you can only take it day to day. And everything's gonna be okay, it'll be okay.
Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Roll it up for the good times. Pour it out for the bad times. Hit my knees and pray. I say goodbye to yesterday. I wake, then I bake. And everything's okay, and everything's okay, yeah.
Love that she give to me.
High grade, high grade.
Are you feeling like a shadow of yourself? Is your mood on its way down? You could be suffering from low THC, also known as cannabinoid deficiency, caused by 77 years of government interference via prohibition. Do you live in a medical cannabis state or the District of Columbia? Are you over the age of 18 and seeking non-toxic natural health, well-being, and peace of mind? Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. After 10,000 years of recorded human use and 77 years of failed prohibition on the world's most extensively tested plant, the results are in. Cannabis has no known lethal dose and is arguably the safest and most comprehensive therapeutic substance known to man. Cannabis remained in the United States pharmacopoeia until 1941, and cannabinoids are currently patented by the federal government as an anti-inflammatory. U.S. patent 6630507. Human brains have cannabinoid receptors. Cannabinoids are lubricants in the human body. Due to prohibition, our bodies have been denied essential lubrication. Imagine never changing or adding to the oil in your car. The use of cannabis for low THC may cause immediate relief, including a general feeling of well-being, chronic smiling or laughing, feelings of euphoria, increased creativity or clarity, a greater appreciation for music and art, the desire to dance, increased feelings of inspiration, compassion or unity, a need for truth and justice, or you may wake feeling more well-rested than usual. It's undetermined to know exactly how many symptoms the use of cannabis may alleviate because of federal prohibition. There were dozens identified in the 1909 Eli Lilly Pharmaceutical Handbook. Currently, over 80% of the population supports the right to use cannabis therapeutically, and 92% of its users have declared significant non-toxic relief. The most common side effects, which are usually mild to moderate and may fade or disappear completely over time, are dry mouth and drowsiness. Other more serious side effects can include growing and repairing brain cells and DNA, or improve vision, may prevent Alzheimer's, dementia, glaucoma, nausea, and suicide, may provide relief from autism, asthma, anorexia, arthritis, AIDS, cancer, Crohn's, depression, epilepsy, fibromyalgia, gout, IBS, insomnia, MS, migraine, pain, Parkinson's, PTSD, and spasticity. Use caution while driving or doing other physical activities until you know how cannabis affects you. May cause paranoia or nervousness, specifically caused by real-life government intervention in your quest for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness in the USA. Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. Brought to you as a public service announcement by The People's Plant, a campaign of conscience.
Good morning, everybody. Have you got that wake and bake in yet? If you haven't, take a sip of coffee. And for those who work in the cannabis industry, before you take another puff, you might want to catch this article. This is by is in Forbes magazine, online edition, and this is by a friend of mine, Mike Adams. He's a conservative with Vices. Marijuana users are being turned away from cannabis industry jobs. That's probably why I ain't got one right now. When the first rules of operating a successful black market drug dealing operation is to never get high on your own supply. Well, it turns out this thug life ethos is being practiced by parts of the legal cannabis industry. Medical marijuana cultivation dispensaries and other pot-based businesses operating a post-prohibition landscape are reportedly rejecting applicants with a strong admiration for weeds. Even those married by marijuana-related criminal convictions are often turned away. The overall message is, while the stoners and potheads may be the ones responsible for the pre-state pot reform in America, they are not in it. A lot of cases not welcome to work in weed. In Florida, where the state's medical marijuana market is just now starting to build some momentum, cannabis operations are in a frenzy to hire bud tenders, cultivators, and cultivation experts, and various other team members to assist in serving the hundreds of thousands of patients expected to participate in the program. The state already has over 147,000 patients in the pool. So finding quality, reliable talent to run the show on top of the most human resources managers. Regardless of their qualifications, such high standards have disqualified the majority of job applications. Only about 10% for those who apply for positions at Florida Cannabis Mart are employable, according to the Orlando Sentinel. This is not entirely the fault of the cannabis industry. Florida law ditches that all employees' medical marijuana operations be felon-free. So while it's convenient that a job application with a misdemeanor for pot possession could receive the green light to grow and sell marijuana in the legal sector, anyone convicted engaging in those activities pre-legal scene could automatically be blacklisted. In an attempt to combat borderline hypocrites and some job recruitment firms like Miami-based Hempstairs are telling people interested in securing a cannabis industry job, they should avoid bringing up any illegal opportunity regarding cannabis in an interview, bragging about growing primo black market bud or being on top of selling the weed swinging the cutter is not the thing you should be listing on a resume. The no store allowing policy is not as prominent in states that have legalized the leaf for recreational. In fact, the study published early this summer, the American Journal of Industrial Medicine found that a large percentage of cannabis industrial workers in Colorado are getting high both before and during business hours. Researchers at Colorado State University found that 63% of the state cannabis industry employees showed up high on the job within the last month, with another 45% many getting stoned on the clock. So obviously there are plenty of cannabis companies hiring people passionate about maintaining a daily buzz. So, now keeping all that in mind right there, just think about it for a second. In Colorado, exactly where I originated and started doing this myself, we definitely got high during, before, and after, and on the air. So, I do know that for a fact to be true. And I'm having electronic issues here today, ladies and gentlemen. So if things seem to get a little crazy this morning, you understand why. I forgot to plug in my phone, my iPad. The only thing that was plugged in was my computer. So, oh, excuse me. Yes, I have not waked and baked yet. I have not even had a cup of coffee yet because I've been trying to pray that my stuff would charge up. I think me and Apple are going to have a conversation today because I think they're trying to get me on. Oh, we're going to slow the roll on and try to get us a new Apple. No, I can't afford new Apple right now. So something going to have to give. So we're going to try working those things out. Today is Tuesday. Oh, by the way, if you live in the states of Arizona and Florida, you need to get out and go do your part and vote. And you already know what I'm going to say without even saying it. Make sure the governor's days is numbered. Make sure he go ahead and be going and getting the boot soon so he can go ahead and make his appointment with U-Haul or Mayflower or whoever he decided to do it to so he can get the hell out the governor's mansion. See you later, dude. Peace be with you. That's in the state of Florida. Now, Arizona, y'all got a pickle in itself. Woo! That race down there in Arizona, it's a hot mess. I can't even say anything, but it's a hot mess. So, when y'all go to the polls, y'all vote at your own risk and good luck because if you notice the candidates, it's like the 2016 election is that bad and bad. So good luck. And if you ain't told somebody yet to tune in, you need to tell them to tune in daily Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on 710 Mott. That's right. 710 Mott out of Denver, Colorado. And also, Dynasty Media's a Poho. This is covering over 14 million people. That's right. Yes, so join us, be honest. And this will be going to Roku soon. And they're also working at getting me on video. Thank God they got me on video today because I look hot mess. So we're going to go ahead and get this back started. We're going to fight to try getting other stories out to you. We got them pulled, but they're just out there in cyberspace. So we're having difficulty trying to get those up to you, but we're going to make it work somehow anyway. We're going to get you a little bit of music whilst we try to fight these difficulties. Get tuned to the Wake and Bake Show.
Always follow your dreams. intergalactic, man.
How you feeling, Alcyon?
Man, thanks for asking. A fantastic, straight up amazing, highly unusual, beautiful vibrations. Transmissions beaming back and forth eternally. Cause Alcyon, I came to burn away the 33rd degree absurdities. Don't get it twisted. Cause there are two sides, dark and light, in this crazy life we live in. So I try to keep it fixed on the positive. I used to get shwilly, now I'm chilling with the Rasta kids. Replace my 40 with the clean canteen. Replace the cigarettes with a fat spliff of green. Now I mean, I'm doing my best to live the dream. I cultivate the body, keep it natural and clean. Like a stream, I'm flowing from the source. Ha, I listen as the lion roars. Bless up the righteous. I can always remember that you are your kings and queens. Listen to your hearts and always follow your dreams. Always remember to stay positive. Yeah, 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 yeah. Bless up the righteous. I can always remember that you are your kings and queens. Listen to your hearts and always follow your dreams. Always remember to stay positive. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I'm the Kabbalistic, alchemistic, dreadlock Palladian. Star surfer, earthling, proverbial Arcadian. Time traveling, elf battling. Closes in, yes, the noosphere prevails. Children live organically, the birds get back the canopies. No longer are we ruled by an oil-based insanity. Cars go electric, people riding bikes more. This could be our future, man, tell me what you're fighting for. It's up to us and ain't ever gonna change. Stop depending on the suits, it's up to you to rearrange your priorities. What's your position? Are you satisfied with the quality of life you live in? Are you in heaven, man, or are you in prison? Man, y'all don't even know the half of what you're missing in a vision.
Bless up the righteous, see. I can always remember that you are your kings and queens. Listen to your hearts and always follow your dreams. Always remember to stay positive. Yeah, 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 yeah. Bless up the righteous, see. I can always remember that you are your kings and queens. Listen to your hearts and always follow your dreams. Always remember to stay positive. Yeah, 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 yeah.
And we're back. We got one for you, boy. Now, this has been a controversy for years for those who's been in the cannabis scene and know anything about cannabis. This is from Leafy, and this is in the Health and Science Division. Schizophrenia may lead to cannabis use, not the other way around. A study that was published today in the journal Natural Neuroscience makes a bold claim that the relationship between cannabis use and schizophrenia. Researchers found that the evidence supporting the theory that cannabis can be cause schizophrenia was weak, but found strong support of the idea that schizophrenia can cause or increase cannabis use. I found this may not indicate the individuals at risk for developing schizophrenia experience the symptoms that make more likely to start using cannabis or the coat or set Medicaid, wrote the study's authors. The preview report, which included contributors from more than 80 researchers around the world, was based in the largest generic study of cannabis ever undertaken. Scientists have long suspected a connection between cannabis use and schizophrenia, but the research remains unclear about the possibility cause relationship between the two. Previous reports had cannabis and schizophrenia. The National Neuroscience Study was based on a gene testing of 184,000 people to include 22 clients of 23andMe, the personal health and ancestry company. That's why I'm not so ready to do that, because they are up in your business, but we shall continue. The study was also coordinated by the International Cannabis Consortium, a project to identify genetic risk variants for cannabis use. Previous studies have shown the generic risk factors for cannabis use and schizophrenia are possibly correlated, the authors noted. In general, those studies have indicated that cannabis use among young people does not itself cause schizophrenia. The evidence has been pointed more to a dynamic where cannabis use can speed up the emerging of the mental disorder among those who have a genetic predisposition to the disease. That's especially critical concern because studies have shown the earlier schizophrenia manifests a person's life more difficult to control and efficiently manage. It's breaking new ground. In the current GMO-wide association study, researchers confirmed a significant genetic correlation between cannabis use and schizophrenia instead of cannabis causing the early emergence of schizophrenia. When they're going to keep going on and talking about that. I just found that to be really interesting that they would find out such a relationship like that. And because I've always heard, oh, that leads to schizophrenia, it leads you to go crazy, and da 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 da. Horse hockey. There's your proof. Now, you can find that, I don't believe I shared that yet on Facebook, but the stories I'm pulling today is off of Twitter. That's right. Follow me at Miss Green Jeans and make sure you're at @Twitter.com to check these stories out. Also, one more I'm going to get to you if it'll let me. This is from NPR.org. That's right. NPR.org. How to pot, how high-end California chefs are cashing in on marijuana. See, this is one story that I'm a foodie. I love food, okay? Bottom line, if I can eat it, I can do it. But this is the California experience. Leave it to California, combine high-end cuisine with a kind of ingredient that might actually get you high. It is increasing lucrative riches for chefs in San Francisco and Los Angeles. Cities already known for trendy food culture. Chefs and entrepreneurs making cannabis-infused foie gras and stone snowfalls are featured in that but 1-2 series devoted to the gourmet ganja. The next fleet's competitive program, Cooking on High, and the Viceland show, Bon Appetit. Bon Appetit is coming out with a cookbook this fall. One of the contributors is co-host Vanessa Lover owns Marigold Sweets, a cannabis cafe in Los Angeles specializing in handmade organic pot-infused truffles. She's a challenge for chef working with the legal cannabis and a newfangled alchemy of dosing. Just to add a little herb to libido so it doesn't even need to get you high. It shouldn't overwhelm you. Lavanda is a musky, flavoring, long associated with the weed is once thought to drown out the other ingredients, but the change thanks to new cultivation processing techniques by all the cannabis cultivating sprung into a wake of legalization. You don't have to taste anything to want to do this. They have distillery. They have different concentrates that concentrate down the THC or the CBD. THC compound that users get high. CBD is different. It is another cannabis compound that lacks the psychoactive properties. Fans believe CBD relieves anxiety and pain and become popular ingredient in cocktails. One upscale restaurant in downtown Los Angeles is dedicated an entire menu. The prefix power lunch at Springs features CBD such as dishes in English pea soup, bernese pecan, and espadette and peach pomacotta. Okay. like putting herb seeds on a salad, which people do, says Yazin Chato. And her husband, Chef Tony, is going to take CBD every day to feel more balanced and healthy. It is easily, legally, to serve gourmet food with CBD than THC. But state and local laws are changing so quickly, it is tricky to keep up. Punch-focused chefs have to grapple with everything from childproof containers to where you can actually consume your fancy edibles. California chefs interested in creation, Michelin Word-Free Pot restaurant has been hampered, for example, from regulating, preventing customers from buying and consuming cannabis in the same place. There are a few exceptions, but this year, West Hollywood is granted a few new licenses for cannabis consumption areas that might transfer the city into a destination for upscale cannabis tourists. Imagine a high-end West Coast Amsterdam, says Vanessa Letrato. That would be so cool. Now that would get me to go to California in a heartbeat. To read more of this story, check it out on npr.org or check it out on my Twitter page. Now, that's something I can get behind if they do something like that. And it just goes on to talk more about CBD. But at that rate, we could do that out here on the East Coast as well. You know, because we have a lot of people that is, you know, combining CBDs in the different, you know, I've seen CBD coffee. I've seen CBD edibles at some shows I went to. But this is the thing I want to see. I want them to come up with some low-calorie stuff. You know, all these high calorie CBD treats. That's not helping my figure none whatsoever. So can somebody come up with some calorie friendly CBD treats and let me know about them? I'd be happy about that. Hey, but that's just my daydream. Like I said, matter of fact, we've also tried the chocolates. We haven't had the coffee yet. The coffee was a little expensive. I think the coffee was like $48. So we gonna have to talk to the coffee manufacturer and see can we have them to send me a sample or something, because I can't see spending $40 on, and this was a regular pound of coffee, okay? If I'm gonna pay $40 for a pound of coffee, it damn sure better have THC and CBD in it. I'm just saying. That's just me. But we're gonna go ahead and get y'all back to some music. We're gonna try to get you one more story before my tablet dies. You're in tune to the Wake and Bake Show. I'm your host.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Feelings so deep in my feelings. Notice they ain't really like me. Can't control my anxiety. Like I'm touching the ceiling. When I'm with you, I can't breathe. Boy, you do something to me. Me high like you do. Listen to my heart go by.
Di-di-da-do, it just won't stop, it go. Head over heels in love, right in front of you, I ain't gotta look no more, baby. I wanna build this love, and everything you own, you ain't gotta ask for. You got me boot up, boot up, boot up, boot up. Tell you from the jump, I don't wanna choose you. Got me boot up, boot up, boot up, boot up. Grab me by the waist, baby, pull me closer.
In the host of it, right in the upholstery, somewhere right close to me, just in case the rollers be rolling on the G. My woman keep it in the hosiery. I'm known in my town and on strips where high rollers be. I'm up early where the money folders, sipping Folgers be. A country boy chilling in Brooklyn like Lefty spoke for me.
Fuck with us, you fuck with the truth, we speak openly.
Never a rat like Donnie Rasco though, cause ain't no hoe in me.
Notice me, senpai, they cry when I choke the speak. Set this crooked city on fire to light the smokery. Old timer speaker us hushed and touched their rosaries. A lust after greatness, I'm aiming right at his ovaries. Better run from the future, palooka. You acting like it's safe and the revolution's been. There's liars on the loose if we listen to you. We're the takers of the jewels, never singing a tune in.
My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama.
That boy levitate. God gifted man, how the fuck they try to legislate? Mom, she recover and tell me I over medicate. I tell her, holy fuck, Jesus Christ, give me a fucking break. She says, don't curse your mama, goddammit, and threw a dinner plate. Damn.
I heard it in Brooklyn where all the sinners stay. You running out of ways to go fuck yourself, I will innovate. The skinniest shitty grin will disintegrate. Every sickening sentence will cheapen them tricks you venerate. Set the phases to face plate, incinerate. Run the jewels, run with the board, baby, assimilate.
My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right. She said I'm crying on ya. She said I waited up for you all night. I said I'm trying, mama. My mama said that I'm not living right.
They want us dying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right.
But I ain't crying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right.
You raised a lie, mama. I ain't lying, mama.
My mama said that I'm not living right. I said I'm trying, mama.
I'm crying on you.
They hit the ground, when you're under the influence of marijuana and you choose to get behind the wheel, you know it's wrong. So if you don't listen to your instincts, think about your fellow passengers or think about the other people on the road, even the unexpected ones. And if you don't think about them, you'll answer to us. Drive baked, get busted.
And we're back. We finally had to put it on charge, guys. Hey, it's like this. It happens sometime. I did some stuff, you know, yesterday trying to, you know, you do some things for so many years and your clock just automatically kicks in. For me, it's like fall cleanup time because that's what I'm used to doing in that time of year. So I've been around here doing some, trying to get some extra cleaning done. Also, with all that, you know, I can only do so much at a time and then stop and then do so much time and stop. And so it's a long progress. But that's what happened. I fell asleep without plugging in my iPad or my phone. So it's nobody's fault but my own. So hey, I hate to say it, but shit happens sometimes. And, you know, that's what happens when you deal with live radio. I'm glad I was able to get y'all a couple of stories. I'm going to check it again in a few minutes to see if we can go ahead and get you that last story out there. Hey, but I like to tell your story. That's right. You can call into the show, or better yet, if you're in North Carolina, South Carolina, depending on if my transportation will be up and running within the next week or so, I'll be glad to come out and we can wake and bake together live on radio. Or better yet, we can go ahead and get it on video and live. is your choice. So however you want to do it. How you contact me is simple. You can reach me, since we're talking about Twitter today, you can go ahead and put Miss Green Jeans and make sure you add that number one at Twitter. You can reach me there, or you can reach me on Facebook. I have several ways you can be reached there. I can be reached at Miss Green Jeans on Twitter, also from Minorities for Medical Marijuana, South Carolina. I am the chapter president. We're definitely needing help there in that area. You can reach me there, or you can reach me on my personal Facebook page as well. On Instagram, Miss Green Jeans as well. Debbie, Miss Green Jeans. If just Google me, hell, you find a way to reach me that way. Believe me, Google even got me covered. So Google need to start paying me, because I'm tired of talking for free. Hey, Google, can you hook a sister up, since she be mentioning you all the time? Because if you ever notice, I do talk about Google a lot, not because they're paying me. It's the part that how I get some of my stories, my information, everything, or something that I have questions about, and me and somebody else is in the debate, I say, hey, Google, and Google does the rest. So, and then Google thought nice enough to make sure I had a spot in the Google sphere. So thank you very much, Google, for hooking a sister up. When she says Google me, that means a lot. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and get you the last talk of the day with this. You know, I normally talk about sharing is caring, which is true in my world, but sometimes you can't get out to share the care. For those who don't know, I've had 2 back-to-back knee replacements in the last 2 years, which makes it kind of difficult. And also right now, financial means is not what they used to be. I'm still waiting on disability. That is correct. So when I do these shows, I'm doing these shows free of charge. I'm not making any advertising money on none of these at this current time, none whatsoever. So if somebody knows an advertiser or somebody that wants to sponsor the show, hey, have them to call us up. We could really use the help. Because sooner or later, I'm going to have to cut the cord. You know, much as I enjoy the show, I got to make money somehow. And I just don't want to quit on this idea whatsoever. But at the same time, I can't afford to be buying equipment out of pocket. Because as of now, my pockets are empty. I've donated the last 5 years of doing this till it hurts. And as of now, it hurts to the point now that I've lost transportation. I'm in a hoopty, but I get from point A to B when I can. Between that and that, you know, not being able to work because of the 2 knee replacements, and probably will never be able to go back to work again because I can lift less than 10 pounds. So I'm looking to do ambassadorships. I'm looking to do whatever I can in the cannabis community, and that's my stipulation. I've dedicated going into my 5th year of doing this, so. You know, somebody out there is looking for a dependable person. I still would like to be able to keep up my podcast here on 710 and Dynasty Media Poho. So that's one of the stipulations. So you know anybody that looking for somebody that be a good ambassador for their product, goods or service in the cannabis community, please have them to contact me as well. And that's my thought of the day. Yes, we will be willing to locate if the price is right. That is correct. We will be willing. You heard me right. We will be willing to locate if the price is right. So just keep that in mind as well. Anyway, it's about 44 minutes after the hour. And make sure you do this for me, guys and gals. I know a lot of us, we talk about it on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. But do we actually get out in public and talk about our cannabis use, or better yet? I know it's a scary thought to do that sometimes for a lot of people. And everybody's not me. But the point of it is this. I always say this, you can hide from God. You can't hide. You can hide from man, but you can't hide from God. So I look at it like this here. I'm not hiding from God, so why should I hide from man? It helps me, and you should be able to tell people it would help them too if they just give it a try. That's what the problem is with a lot of people. They go by propaganda and bullshit. And I hate to put it that way. That's what we've been fed for over 50-some years, propaganda and bullshit. So now that people are finding out that this thing is working, and we got a pharmaceutical company that's on the edge right now of bringing it to come off of Schedule 1, which is going to be a problem in itself. If GW Pharmaceuticals gets their product that they just tested, and I think they're having some positive results with this test. I don't know yet. I'm still looking on research on that. If that happens, they have the power to bring it off of Schedule 1. But we all know that opens up a can of worms for a lot of other things. And I personally don't want my cannabis commercialized, because we know what happens when that happens. So let the debate begin on that note. Anyway, that's my last talk of the day, guys. So make sure you check out minoritiesformedicalmarijuana.org. Yeah, they have a lot of good stuff going on. If you're thinking about getting in the cannabis industry, that's one people you definitely want to do. But like I said, once again, for those states that are making it hard for people to get in the cannabis industry, that love this industry more than anything else because of their cannabis use, boo on you. Boo on you for that. Because just because we use cannabis, you know, doesn't mean we're going to be using your cannabis. You trying to say pothead still, in other words. That's what you're trying to say in the short slick end. No, we ain't like that. Some is, but I can't speak for everybody, but some are not. So I think the laws need to be looked at on that story, because I know it to be so true. And some people, when they go to events, you know, they're in the cannabis industry, and I'm not trying to call nobody out, but let the truth be told, they're still smoking. They just don't want nobody to know they're smoking. And I'm just telling you as of now to be super careful, because I understand you want to be well and everything, but it's so not worth you losing your job, okay? Because they're hard to come by. You made it, so keep it that way. Just keep it on the DL, all right? All right, guys, y'all have a great Tuesday. We'll be back Wednesday. I think we're going to get in contact before Jim. I think I'm going to bring him in on Wednesdays, and we're going to go ahead and get that kickback and start it up again and everything. We're debating, should we do a Labor Day show? I'm still up in debate about that, because that is what it is. Labor Day is supposed to be a day off for most people. Even though I don't get paid or I do work. I don't know. Give me your thoughts on that. Would y'all listen to a Labor Day show, or will I just spin in my wheels because everybody's sleeping in late? Your thoughts. You're in tune to the Wake and Bake Show.
I pray thee once again. I wonder if it's surrounded by ones of such talent. You know? Speak life. Live a humble and meek life. Ordinary day of the week life. Try to search and seek life. Way up. Keep your head up and stay up. Even when you're sore and pain up. Never giving up till it's game up. Keep your aim up and focus. Don't concentrate on what's bogus. Never sell out for a bonus. Handle your biz like grown-ups. Own up. It's amazing. The way your fire keeps blazing. That's why you're constantly praising. For some of them it's a face thing, so they're gazing. On the street lights, them go catch up in street fights. Cause I'm pretending they're street wise. And put an end to a brief life. I feel like it's a mystery. life lessons missed with. It's risky, so give praises. One day you may find your oasis. Rise up to the challenge you're faced with. Be your fool and creative. You'll make it. It's basics. People been doing. Too much time has been wasted, man, building military bases, fighting a war with no basis. Life is sacred, and every baby born naked. Someone a go on like them.
I got one question for you. Are you awake yet?
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think. I can be. I'm the one at the sail. I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, ooh. I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the.
Yeah. the blood in my veins, oh, ooh, the blood in my veins, oh, ooh. But they never did, ever lived, ebbing and flowing, inhibited, limited, till it broke up when it rained down like...
They're hard to learn with though because they're slippery.
They are slippery.
Compared to like blue ones and shit.
They are slippery, but once you get that, like, take a breath.
Take a breath. Been trying to ignore it lately. Sometimes life can drive me crazy. I stay with my vision hazy. Please don't ask me why. I trip up over nothing. Always down about something. Worried about all the wrong things. I can't justify. Why don't we roll up another? I got a lot on my mind. Tonight get high and discuss. That's why you gotta puff, puff, pass. Relax a little bit, take a breath and exhale. Done. Puff, puff, pass. Cause once you get a hit, you won't really care about whether you're rich or if you're broke. Watch your worries go up in smoke and just puff, puff, pass. Relax a little bit, take a breath and exhale. Faded, don't know what the vibe is later. But I brought the rolling papers. If you want to get high, I'm over stressing out. So don't wait, the time is now. Gotta get up to get down. So if that's what you like, why don't we roll up another? I got a lot on my mind. Tonight get high and discover. That's why you got.
Take a breath and exhale. Just